Welcome to Mount Pinatubo, a volcano that erupted less than 35 years ago, guys. And guess what we're going to do today? Go trekking up it. Good morning, guys. We have the sound of Asia waking us up with all thousands of cockerels. It is currently
5:09.
And guess what we're doing today? I am so excited. We are about to climb an active volcano. It's something that we've never done before, so it's like bucket list moment today that we're buzzing about. We stayed up last night reading all of like facts and watching documentaries on when it last erupted, and it's super interesting. We'll tell you more about that later, but first thing, we need to get a coffee and to have some breakfast.
Thank you.
Got ourselves some breakfast. I don't know if 5 a.m. is probably too early, but we didn't have any dinner last night because the gluten-free options in this town is non-existent, so I thought I need to eat before this. It's not really much of a hike, it's more of a trek, like an hour trek, but yeah, get some food in us.
It's now 5:30, our 4x4 has arrived. We've finished our breakfast, so we're nice and refreshed, and I'm more awake now, so yeah, excited.
Adopted from marine stroller.
Oh wow.
Good morning.
I thought you were serious. I'm too gullible. Thank you.
Be safe.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Have fun.
Thank you.
All right, see you soon.
Thank you. Bye. So we've just hopped in the 4x4 and the guy said, because obviously we're videoing slash for our experience, would we rather have an open top one? So I think we're swapping cars. I think I would. I think it'd be a cooler experience, even though it's a bit annoying. But here's all the cockerels that were going off this morning.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
5:90. Oh yeah, this is cool.
This is cool.
Yeah, this is cool. We weren't sure if we were going to get like a private tour or whether it's going to be other people because we didn't know what was happening really, but it looks like it's just the two of us, which is exciting.
I'm not sure exactly what I've signed away, but I'm guessing if you go into an active volcano, probably your life. Last night when we were in bed, we literally heard like so many helicopters, planes, like proper loud noise. We're like, what's going on? But we've just realised that we're right next to an air base in the Philippines, so that makes sense. I think part of the reason we had to,
we had to
give our passports over to like an army guy when we came into the town. I think it's because of that. There's loads of army guys coming up.
That's the army base in the distance. We weren't sure if we could film or not, but they were friendly as we drove through, giving us the usual Filipino smile and wave. I think this just added to the excitement and nerves of the day. Driving to an active volcano through an active army base. Like, what the hell?
Gone through a proper river.
Yeah, I was like, jumped out the back. The first part of this tour is to drive along like the base of, it feels like a river, but it's all black ash from when it erupted ages ago. So it's really cool, but we've also got the sunrise as we speak as well. So it's really beautiful and also very bumpy, but it's so cool. Yeah. And then there's mountains all around, but they're not very tall at all. Like, I reckon it'd take me like half an hour to run at one of them. Probably not, but yeah, it's nothing like I've ever seen before. I would never have expected this in the Philippines at all. It's crazy. We're just sat here with our mouths open the whole time. Look at that, look at that, look at that.
In a second car that was like half submerged in what we think was ash from the eruption like 20 years ago. Which is pretty cool to see, but harrowing at the same time.
Driving through a full-on river, and you can see why. Number one, you can't do it by yourself and you need a 4x4, and number two, yeah, why you need a 4x4.
I was gonna drive our motorbike down here.
Guys, it's like, what do you mean we can't walk it ourselves? And also, if it is rainy season and it's been a really bad like typhoon, you can't go, because obviously this will be so flooded. But yeah, there's water spraying everywhere. It's so fun.
We're literally in the middle of nowhere, aren't we?
Yeah,
So we've gone from Manila to a town that's kind of in the middle of nowhere, to then a smaller town that's in the middle of nowhere, to then an hour on a jeep out to the volcano. It's pretty cool, but pretty crazy. So the closer that we get to the volcano, the closer we get to the volcano, the harsher the terrains become. It seems like the mountains are a lot higher beside us, and there's so many more like loose rocks and stuff on the floor. Yeah,
takes some serious skill, doesn't it?
It's crazy. Yeah, some serious driving skills here. I'm getting thrown around. It's fun though. So it looks like there's been like a mudslide there at some point.
Are you scared?
Morning. How are you?
Hi.
Thank you. It will be. We'll try. So, look at my hair. So, we've just got off. This is the start of the walk. It was at least an hour's drive, wasn't it?
Yeah.
We were saying, if someone had shown us drone footage of that drive before we set off, we would have said, there is no chance in hell a car would get through that.
It looks to me like, you know, when you see videos of people getting to K2 base camp in Pakistan. Have you seen that?
Yeah.
It looks like, honestly, some of the things we drove over, it was like a proper 4x4 ride.
Yeah, I would have paid good money just to do the ride. It was mental, and it got scarier and scarier as we got in, because the terrain got so dramatic. You just thought, if something happens, we are not getting out of here quickly at all. So I'd like to say to my friends and family, I love you. Thanks to the Philippines for this opportunity. And if anything happens, then we had a good life. But I am on pure buzzing. Thank you.
Thank you.
as we've said, this is an active volcano. However, the most scary part is it had a humongous eruption in 1991, which killed loads of people. It was the second largest eruption in the 20th century and actually changed the whole world's temperature by 1 degree Fahrenheit. It was huge, and we sat up last night watching documentaries on it because it was like so interesting, but also it scares you because then obviously it was dormant for 500 years. People lived around the mountain, around the volcano, because obviously if nothing's happened for 500 years, you don't expect it to go off. And if it does erupt now, yeah, there's nowhere to go. So it's pretty terrifying, but exciting at the same time. Everybody loves the risk, don't they? But yeah, it was horrible to hear about the devastation it caused.
As we progressed through the trek, the true power of the volcano became increasingly evident through the ever-changing terrain. The landscape seemed to bow to the volcano's might, with rugged, ash-covered slopes giving way to lush valleys that had once been shaped by its eruption. It was as if nature itself acknowledged the volcano's authority, and with each step, we couldn't help but feel small, humbled, and awestruck by the immense force that had shaped this awe-inspiring landscape.
Oh, that's cool.
So 30 years here.
30 years. Oh, that's cool. So yeah. Look, charcoal from the last eruption 30 years ago. Yeah, crazy.
Write your name.
Really feel the power of the rivers, can't you, when you're trying to cross them? They're only like up to your ankles, but they're almost taking you off your feet.
Yeah.
So this mountain here is just asphalt,
yeah,
from the eruption. Crazy.
It's what?
It's just from the eruption.
Oh, asphalt. Really?
So it must have been massive eruption, yeah.
Since you came here 35 years ago, this wouldn't have been here.
Yeah.
It's just a build up from the eruption. Safe.
So you can see here the river flows orange, obviously from the volcanic rocks that it's flowing down from, but literally looks like clay compared to the fresh river we've just been walking through, but it's bright orange. It's pretty cool. It's funny, we have these sticks to guide our path now, and there's actually signs coming up. Not that I understand why, because I can't imagine ever doing this without a guide, but also, yeah, odd. Don't know why they need signs, but...
Quick tip as well, it does tell you to wear like trainers or hiking boots, but we've walked through about 10 streams so far, so I would say adventure sandals or Crocs are better, or even just regular flip-flops.
No, agreed, definitely. I'm glad I wore my Crocs. Whoa, so look at that random spike. It's got nothing either side, so it's obviously built up from the eruption.
So our guide just told us that there's 3 records of eruptions for this volcano. One in the late 1500s, one in the 1700s, and then one obviously 30 years ago. So it seems we'll be okay, because it seems about every 200 years or so there's a big eruption here.
Looks like we're arriving at a resting stop. There's some toilets here to our back, and then somewhere to sit and chill for a minute, I think. Whew, I'm a little bit sweaty now, to be fair.
The sign over there says young citizens 15 minutes or senior citizens 20 minutes, and it says, what one are you?
You're senior, I'm young.
No.
Yeah,
no.
Over 30
what, and
senior.
It's like, what one are you?
The start of the main trek, and apparently 4x4s can get to here, but because of the storm and the rivers, they don't anymore, but to be honest, it's nice to have an actual walkthrough. Whoa, this looks dangerous.
All good. Thank you. Thank you.
Whoa. Thank you. Told you. Hey, volcanic ash surfing.
As we made our way to the volcano's final climb, things got pretty interesting. It wasn't the barren, desolate landscape we expected. It turned into a lush green oasis. It felt like a hidden surprise, tucked away in the valley with trees and tall grass. We were so excited to see what waited for us at the crater.
Here we go, the last few steps.
We've made it around this corner, so.
Ooh. Hope it's epic. Same.
Wow, it has exceeded my expectations. It is so beautiful.
Insane.
Yeah, it looks so peaceful, doesn't it? Like, it looks like an absolutely stunning lake, and you wouldn't know it was a volcano.
Yeah, literally, that erupted less than 20 years ago. Insane.
Yeah, it's epic.
So this is crazy. In the Philippines, you expect to see beautiful beaches, island hopping, but this is insane. And literally the icing on top of the cake, like, stunning. It's probably one of the best things I've ever done. I feel pure buzzing, and we're in the north of Luzon for a couple of weeks, so I'm so excited to see what else it brings. But yeah, we're just sat chilling now. Gaz is eating his crisps, just taking in its beauty. It looks insane. And to sit and think about what actually came out of that and what it looked like before. Obviously, it's really sad, the devastation it caused. Just wild to be close to the crater of a volcano.
As we tracked back down the volcano, saying we were on cloud nine doesn't quite cover it. If there's one thing we'd wholeheartedly recommend in the Philippines, it's this. Describing the emotions we experienced today is a challenge in itself. My heart hasn't stopped racing since the minute I woke up. From the breathtaking sunrise at 5 a.m, to the most exhilarating 4x4 journey across terrain we couldn't even imagine before today, complete with river crossings and hiking through volcanic ash from an eruption less than 35 years ago. It's been a whirlwind. And of course, reaching the incredibly tranquil crater where all this destruction began. The day has been a rollercoaster of emotions, a mix of excitement, fear, sadness, and awe at this incredible power of our world. This is a day we'll never forget, and one I know we'll be telling our children in years to come.
So if you want to do the tour exactly how we've done it, we are in a little town called Santa Juliana, which is just about a 45-minute drive away from Capas, and we've got a bus there from Manila.
And our hotel is called CASA Hermogina, which is where we booked the tour with. So we booked the tour directly from the hotel, from the guy that owns it. So it was nice and easy to organise, wasn't it?
Yeah, and it cost us $7,500 to do the actual volcano trek. Yeah, if you want to do that, I'll leave all of the information in the description below as well, so you can look all that stuff. If you've enjoyed the video, make sure you give us a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and we'll see you in the next one.